The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Trader's Edge with Steve Rhodes. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648 or internationally at 727-873-7618. The Trader's Edge. Now, Steve Rhodes.
Good morning, folks. Welcome to the December 12th, the terrific Tuesday edition of today's Trader's Edge show. I'm your host, Stevie Perseverance Rhodes, who absolutely knows that each of us should always be pioneers of our future versus prisoners of our past. Hope everyone out there is having a great day. Hey, let's make sure we have an extraordinary one. Now, the easiest way to do that is to always remember that life is happening for us, not to us. That's right. When you and I make that one little 2x4 shift, it means we can find the gift in every set of circumstance that life is going to toss at us. Now, today, you and I, we're going to go check on the circumstance of these markets. We'll go figure out what those bulls and bears, what those buyers and sellers are communicating to you and I at just past 11 o'clock in the morning. I want you to know I'm absolutely grateful for your presence here, but even more important than that, and that's this, during this next 53 minutes, I'm here to serve you. So feel free to give us a call at 877-927-6648. We'd love to hear from you. Now, if you've got a question, but you can't call in, we've got you covered. Send me an email. Send that off to Steve at TFNN.com. And inside the subject heading, please put radio show question. Of course, if you're inside our Tiger's Den, well, then any and every ping will do. So let's go ahead and get this show started on Terrific Tuesday. Of course, this is Tiger Financial News Network. I'm Steve Rhodes. Welcome to the show. Right now, we got a bit of a mixed bag out there. The mix is really coming from the Russell and the New York Stock Exchange. Russell's down 4, New York Stock Exchange off 10. The other U.S. indices we track to the upside, 122 for the Dow, 0.3%. About 0.1% for the S&P or 7 points, 0.3% for the NASDAQ, 159 points, 0.5% for the semis, 22. Trannies up 0.7, that's over 100 points. We've got gold up $4. Silver is now flat. Light sweet crude is anything but flat. It's down 240. Natural gas up almost 6 cents. 30-year treasury printed out 119.09. That's 9 ticks to the upside. If we take a look at what the leaders in the clubhouse to the upside are, that goes to Broadcom. $28, 2.7% move. Linde PLC, $14, 3.5%. ServiceNow, $10, 1.5%. Delavin Health, 2%, nearly 10. Synopsys is up by 1.5%. That's about a $9 move. To the downside, it's Mercado Libre. $14, 1%. Oracle down 12, $13, 11% there. CareCloud Inc. is down $10 or 67%. That's a stinger. First Solar down $6, 5%. Enphase Energy off about 6%, about a $6 move to the downside. So where do we want to begin? Where do we want to begin? I tell you where we'll begin. Let's go take a look at the daily equity future contracts. Let me switch over to a different set of charts out here. We'll go to those white background charts. They've got the clearer picture for us with regard to what's going on there, what we have to be paying attention to. So in the upper left-hand corner, you're going to see the end. Oh, I've got the day trading charts up, so to speak. Give me a second here. Let me get back to here. So now we've got the daily time frame charts. First thing to know about this morning, we had that nice little brief pullback, right? That brief pullback, what did it do on the ES Mini? Pulled right back, tested and rejected that green oscillator and change line. That's a beautiful thing. So the momentum to the upside still exists inside the ES Mini. Only a close below that would suggest otherwise. It right now being 46.63. We do have a wave number 7 pattern that is present. That is a letter G that needs a lower high to confirm. That means we couldn't get confirmation of that until tomorrow at 5 p.m. What else do we know? We've got a Rhodes momentum indicator signal that's been triggered. That needs a bearish reversal candle to identify a top out there. So we'd be on the lookout for that. We take a look at the NQ. The NQ, it's showing a wave number 7, but that one of the black digits, yeah, I'm going to say no to that one. Really, you're only in wave number 4, 5 to the upside E. So that's the correct count out there. It's got a Rhodes momentum indicator signal, negated a Rhodes momentum indicator, TD9 count pattern yesterday. This wants to continue higher. It's straight above profile, straight above its green oscillator and change line. Only a bearish reversal candle would say otherwise. We've got the same set of patterns inside the Dow, wave number 7. A Rhodes momentum indicator signal, no other bottom. Yesterday negated its sell the D point. I'm sorry, negated its TD9 count top out there. The Russell 2000, right now today, it's got a key reversal bar. And the key reversal bar here would confirm a Rhodes momentum indicator top for it. Should that happen, now, in order for that to occur, you just need to see the Russell 2000 equity future contract close one tick below its open. Short of that, if it closes above that level, then we don't have a bearish reversal candle. You may also get a bearish engulfing candle today. Do you need two bearish reversal signals to confirm a top? No, you just need one of those. So we'll watch the Russell 2000. That's one that's the weakest from a pattern standpoint at 11:11 in the morning on December the 12th. But it's about the end of the day that we'll be paying attention to. So summarize all these charts for me, Stevie. If I summarize these charts, we're in full breakout mode on a daily time frame. We take away the ES, the NQ, and the Dow. Why is it in full breakout mode? Because you're above a green oscillator and change line tells us we have a rising price oscillator above zero. Folks, that is bullish. It's just, there's no other way to, that is simply bullish. And prices above the top of their daily profiles. That two are those two are bullish signals out there. So those three are in total breakout mode. That doesn't mean they can't top. It just means the daily timeframes right now, they're in full breakout regalia. Now let's go back to those shorter term time frame charts. I mentioned I first popped up on the screen. Let's take a look at the NQ since that's up there. We take a look at a 5 hour time frame chart out there. I don't know. Do we have a sell the D point pattern? Let's take a look, see if there was an A to B equals CD. I do see the bearish shooting star candle. Yeah, there's an A to B equals CD. So you do have a sell the D point pattern. What did price do? When you get a top, all price is really supposed to do is at least is get back and test support. Again, that's one of the reasons to understand the oscillator and change line. What did price do this morning? Got right back to that and tested and rejected that. In the meantime, it's also created a new profile. Profile support at 16042, resistance at 16490. Well, at 16489, we're trading just above that right now. If you take out today's high, that'll negate that sell the D point pattern to suggest that we head higher. But support is held out there. That's a bullish signal. We look at a 4 hour time frame chart. The 4 hour time frame chart would also have an A to B equals CD pattern out there. That was not, was that a key reversal bar? Which way did it close? Let's see. The open on that bar was 16,466. The close, 16,467. So no key reversal bar there. But you did get a bearish engulfing candle on this bar here at 6 o'clock this morning. So the NQ on its 4 hour time frame chart also has a sell the D point pattern. It's got a new profile, price found support at its oscillator change line at the bottom of its profile. And if price closes above 16489.65, the 4 hour time frame chart will get back to bullishness. Now it could form a TD9 count topping pattern later this afternoon, but that's not the pattern that's in play as we speak right now. 2 hour time frame has a Rhodes momentum indicator top. But here price found support. This is the NQ where a counter trend move would find support, and that's at the center of that bullish structured profile. And that was at the 16441 level. So that just says you got to take out today's high to get back to bullish for that. The same thing for the 60-minute time frame chart. 60-minute time frame chart found support at the bottom of its profile. So here's what we know before we go to the breakout there. If we just take a look at the charts we've looked at for the NQ, we're eliminating the 30-minute, the 15-minute, and the 10-minute. All that took place this morning was price pulling back and testing support levels out there. And all of those have held. Now the question is, will resistance get taken out? And that's basically today's high. Steve Rhodes with TFNN. We'll be right back.
Get ready, Tigers. Thursday, December 14th, Tim Ord is back to host another stellar live webinar. From 4 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. Eastern Time, Tim Ord will delve into the secret science of market tops, helping you, the viewer, with how to effectively call market tops in order to increase your success in trading. Tim Ord has developed this understanding over decades of trading and is ready to impart this knowledge on you. Visit the front page of TFNN.com today to sign up for Tim Ord's secret science market tops. TFNN, educating investors.
If you're looking for potential trading setups in the stock market, then Rocket Equities and Options Report is a newsletter you should try. Tommy O'Brien delivers options and equity trades when the markets present them using a combination of fundamentals and technicals. Sign up for Rocket Equities and Options Report today with a 30-day money-back guarantee so you have nothing to risk. For all the details and to start your subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
You might think that if you want to be successful at trading in the stock market, you're going to need a crystal ball. After all, it's impossible to predict the future, right? Like any endeavor in life, before you decide it's impossible, get some advice from the experts. You might find that it's not so impossible after all. For daily market overviews that give you direction on the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, subscribe to the Opening Call newsletter at TFNN.com. The Opening Call newsletter is written by Basil Chapman, creator of the trading methodology known as the Chapman Wave. The Chapman Wave up-down sequence gives you an edge in identifying price turns, finding the peaks and valleys in stock prices. Get the Opening Call newsletter by Basil Chapman in your inbox every day. First-time subscribers also get a 30-day money-back guarantee. If you're not satisfied, let us know, and you'll get a full refund within 30 days of signing up. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Steve Rhodes started his trading career as a student almost 20 years ago, and the student has now become the master. Steve won the prestigious Timer of the Year award in 2018 and barely missed that mark again in 2019, finishing at number 2 for the year. An amazing accomplishment. Steve Rhodes is committed to sharing his techniques and knowledge with anyone who wants to learn. And he shares his vast amount of trading knowledge every day in his Mastering Probability newsletter. Steve's award-winning newsletter, Mastering Probability, is delivered every trading day with updates throughout the afternoon. Sign up for Steve's market newsletter, Mastering Probability, and you'll receive access to 7 of Steve's educational webinars absolutely free. At TFNN, all our newsletters come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have absolutely nothing to worry about. Visit TFNN.com and try Mastering Probability 30 days risk-free today. TFNN, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. So we're taking, let's get to a couple of requests that have come in. Let's get those out of the way so we don't fall too far behind. The first one is from G-Man, and this is inside the Tigers Den. And G-Man wants to take a look at AMD, and his question is, where is trouble ahead? So we take a look at the charts here for AMD. The trouble ahead for you, the only trouble that I see, and actually what we're going to do is, so we'll switch back to my other charts here momentarily, but the only trouble that I see is really on the daily time frame chart. And that trouble that I'm referring to could be a wave number 7 top out here. Now, I'm going to say that we're really only in wave number 6. This letter G that shows up here is taking us all the way back to this high out here from June 13th. And markets move low enough to say that the count that we really should be watching out here are the black digits. So I don't really see, you know, other than being past wave number 4 out there, that's really the only weakness. We've got confirmed A to B equals CD patterns to the upside out here for AMD. That's what we're going to go take a look at momentarily. If we look at the weekly time frame chart as well, let me open this up, just study this a bit more out here, see where the wave count is coming from. So here I would say you're more likely in wave number 3 than you are in number 7 out there. When we take a look at where we're at on the weekly chart, the weekly suggests that price should go target the 156.73 area. Now, there's Rhodes momentum indicator signal that's triggered. If they were to get a bearish reversal candle, that would confirm a top. Short of that, price should go target the 156.73 area. On a monthly time frame, there is no topping pattern in place. You do have that wave number 4 pattern, but that doesn't complete until you get a lower high out there. So that would be the end of January before you get that signal. So otherwise, that looks pretty good. So that's your only concern, potential concern out here, are the wave counts, the Rhodes momentum indicator signal on the weekly chart out there. You do have A to B equals CD patterns to the upside. And we'll go take a look at those momentarily. We'll switch back to the black background screen. So give me a moment here, G-Man. We'll get those black background screens. And you'll see the A to B equals CD patterns that I'm taking a look at. So here we get to our three different time frames. On the A to B equals CD, the B point on the daily time frame that I'm using is November the 29th. And November the 29th did 37 million shares. That was taken out with 118 million shares, and that was on December the 7th. So your 1-to-1 A to B equals CD gets up to 148 bucks. Now, this retracement is only 28%. You know I like to use at least a 38% retracement. So is that really the A to B equals CD pattern? Well, it doesn't matter whether it is or it isn't at this stage of the game, because on a weekly basis, as long as the week ends and price closes above 132.83, you'll have an A to B equals CD to the upside that's been triggered. Will it have the volume? I don't know. The volume on that swing point from June 12th of 2023 was 481,000. You're at 147. We're too early into Tuesday to know how that extrapolates out, but watch for that. But right now you're trading above the swing point, so that is a positive. And that gives you that price projection of 171.38. And that takes us all the way back to its all-time highs. Those took place in November of 2021. So AMD looks awfully good out there. The only thing, let me see if there's any other A to B equals CD patterns here that you would be concerned with. So here, no, not really. This would get us the same. This would give me the same thing as we've got on the weekly and the monthly. So yeah, the only thing you possibly got out there is that it's really the wave counts. Everything looks good. If I look at a 30-minute time frame chart for you, let me pull this over here to this chart. You know, I think on Friday when I did the shows, you guys, some folks in the den were having problems with the chart clarity and things of that sort. Of course, I've rebooted the system a few times since then, but I'm just checking back in with you, make sure that that problem has gone away. I hope that it has. Here we take a look at a 30-minute time frame chart for AMD. What does this tell us? Well, this tells us that at 11:30, G-Man, you're going to get a TD9 count top, and that would suggest that AMD on the short-term base should pull back to test support. The first level of support would be its oscillator and change line. Currently printed at 136.98 or so, right around there. Price pulls back, tests that, rejects it. Then this time frame gets back to neutral versus a bearish signal out there. If price closes below that, then you could see a move anywhere down to 134.36, 132.32, and 131.90. Those would be your downside price targets. You're still seeing the grayscale yesterday. That's interesting, Dan. So if you do see that, just let me know where that pops up on the screen for you, just so I can try it. My screens look totally clear. So I don't know where that issue is, but I would like to try to track that down. I'd like, you know, as long as you're watching, listening on the show, I'd like you to be able to see these charts clearly out there. So back to AMD out here, G-Man. Stay in that trade. It looks muy bueno, and best of luck to you. The next request was coming in from Aaron, and Aaron was asking about the New York Stock Exchange Advanced Client Oscillator. That means we're going to remain on these black background charts out here. His question was, is there still a divergence? And the answer is yes, there was a divergent pattern. We had talked about that on the trading day, quite frankly. We had talked about it on November 3rd or the day following. Why? Because the advanced client oscillator, that's a difference between the 19 and 39 period exponential moving average of the advanced decline line. When that gets above plus 150, that's the signal that the New York Stock Exchange has now achieved overbought territory. That doesn't mean it turns down right then and there. But in this case here, it got well above 150. In fact, it was the highest high that we had seen since back in March of 2023 out there. And typically, when we get above the plus 150, if you take a look at all those diagonal lines, the way that a top forms inside of the New York Stock Exchange is we see lower highs in the advanced client oscillator with higher highs inside of price. Now, the issue here, there's a couple issues to pay attention to. So the first one, and I've got to get these charts going. That's on my other screen, so I'll get those going. We'll talk about that issue next. In order for this pattern to really get rocking and rolling, Aaron, to the downside, you need to see the spot volatility above its 50-day exponential moving average. And that's why we're not seeing much of a pullback out here, or very little of a pullback. It's because the volatility index is helping this instrument out. But do we still have the pattern? We do. What we've also lost out here, and what we're watching for as well, another thing that you want to confirm that top in that pattern, we can't trade the New York Stock Exchange, but we can use it for a general reading of the markets out there, is one, you're looking for a, let me see, I think we took out the sell the D point pattern. Let me just make sure. 16,271.70, yesterday's close was 16,274.44. So there's no sell the D point pattern any longer because price took out that Three River Evening Star. There's a Rhodes momentum indicator signal that's been triggered. We haven't gotten above yesterday's high. Yesterday's 16,274 is the high so far of the day, 16,278. If we did get above yesterday's high and we did close one tick below the open, you would get a you would get a key reversal bar. That would confirm or sell the D point pattern. That would confirm a Rhodes momentum indicator top. But as you can see here, the New York Stock Exchange has been so super strong out there. And today's move lower was nothing more than a test and rejection of that oscillator and change line. And as long as price remains above that, even if we have a top, conditions will be neutralized. Neutral. Why? Because that still leaves us with a rising price oscillator above zero. So you got to at least get a top inside the New York Stock Exchange, Aaron. And then the next thing, in order for that pattern to really get rolling to the downside, you've got to be able to get that spot volatility certainly rising, but preferably above the 50-day exponential moving average. So hope that that helps you out. We come back from this breakout here. We're going to go take a look at Microsoft for Dennis. We're going to take a look at Apple for Dennis in West Palm Beach. The UNG for Joe, the GDX for Joe. And anything else that you'd like, you just have to either call in at 877-927-6648 or send me an email, steve at tfnn.com, and of course any ping inside the Tiger's Den. We'll be right back.
It's December, Tigers. That means festivities, decorating, spending time with friends and family, and the TFNN Tiger Dollar Holiday Sale. Don't miss your chance to receive a 20, 30, or even a 40% bonus when you purchase Tiger Dollars. Once you apply your Tiger Dollars to your account, you will be able to use them for any TFNN product purchase instead of your credit card. Visit the front page of TFNN.com today to purchase your Tiger Dollars. Don't miss your chance to receive up to a 40% bonus on your Tiger Dollar purchase this holiday season. Every Tiger who purchases Tiger Dollars will also receive a complimentary TFNN Tiger mug with their purchase. Act fast, this sale ends December 17th. Happy holiday, Tigers. TFNN, educating investors. Tigers, tis the season for leveling up your trading skills. Basil Chapman is happy to offer all opening call subscribers a free subscriber webinar, Wednesday, December 20th, 4 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. Eastern. Basil Chapman will be discussing major sectors and stocks that are coming off their lows in order to prepare your portfolio for 2024. This is a free webinar for all opening call subscribers. If you are not yet a subscriber, visit the front page of TFNN.com today to secure your spot for Wednesday, December 20th. TFNN, educating investors.
The Gold Report. As a precious metal, gold is still king. It continues to hold the most effective safe haven and hedging properties across the global major trading hubs of the London OTC market, the U.S. futures market, and the Shanghai Gold Exchange. The Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his weekly Gold Report every Monday morning for subscribers, consisting of coverage of the XAU, HUI, GDX, the dollar, bonds, the South African rand, as well as 25 different mining equities with specific buy-sell recommendations. The Gold Report. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee so you have nothing to risk. Subscribe to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report newsletter now at tfnn.com.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV.
Welcome back, folks. Let's take a look at Microsoft for Dennis, Nancy as well. And the question from Dennis, and I would assume from Nancy, would be, where's Microsoft headed in the short term? So here's what we know. We take a look at the daily time frame chart for Microsoft. Number one, it's got a TD9 count and Rhodes Momentum Indicator top. That has taken price back to the support zone of both its bullish structured profile, and that's between 365.16 and 366.76, as well as testing its TD9 count breakout level at 367. So there's strong support in that area. That was tested yesterday when we were on the show. We had talked about that. I think Microsoft was trading down towards that 366 level. Until that support area holds, until that support level fails, you have to assume every time down it's going to hold. In fact, that's what it did. Now, yesterday was also a test of a swing point. That was a swing point from December 4th. And that swing point had volume of 32 million shares. Yesterday was test and rejected with 27 million shares. That's a test and rejection on light volume. You know the expression that Tom coined out there, if you can't bust them to the downside, and that's that signal from yesterday, you try to bust them to the upside. We're trading above yesterday's high. As long as price remains above yesterday's high, it should go tackle the 374.75 area. That is the top of its daily profile. If price get above that, then you'd be off to 379.31. If I look at a 30-minute time frame chart, which is what we're going to do, on a 30-minute time frame chart, and this 30-minute chart does not finish for another 28 minutes, if price is able to click above 372.42, then you're going to have a 30-minute TD9 count top. And what should then transpire, Dennis, is price should pull back and at least test support. The first level of support would be the oscillator and change line, and that is at 370.79. If price were to close below that, the next level of support would be the top of its profile, 370.28. Below that would be the breakout level, 368.92, and below that would be the bullish structured zone of its 30-minute profile, 367.77, 368.61. So you want to watch. Now, if price is not in this next 30 minutes, click above, tick above, 372.42. Let me see if it's done that. I don't think it has. 370. Oh, it has. 372.47. Let me do this here. There. Okay. So now what you've got is you're going to have a TD9 count top on a 30-minute basis. Again, that completes at 12 noon. So you're going to need to watch support on the intraday time periods to tell you what's going on there. A test rejection of support would be bullish and price should continue to move higher. So that's what I see when I take a look at Microsoft. Yesterday was a down day for Microsoft, meaning it closed below the prior close. I know you can look at it and say, what do you mean, Steve? It was an up day. I'm referring to close versus close. And we take a look at Microsoft. If it does close lower today, you'd be in bar number two to the downside out here. We can see that since its rally off of the September lows for Microsoft, we've seen two consecutive knee-jerk reaction lows. Markets move higher from that out there. So watch the 30-minute time frame chart. I know you're looking at the short-term time frame, so that's what you should be watching there. Let's go on to your next request, which was to take a look at Apple. What is Apple doing? Well, we take a look at Apple. Let's open up this daily time frame chart. Let's see what kind of signals we have out here. What do we have? We have a Rhodes Momentum Indicator top that was confirmed yesterday with a gap to the downside. A gap to the downside is a bearish reversal candle. What did price do? Or what is price doing? Price is just consolidating with inside its daily profile. And that range out there, Dennis, is 190.87. That is support. And resistance is up at 195.14. It's actually a slightly bullish structured profile, so it's really a support or resistance zone, 191.72, 193.45 out there. What do we see on the weekly time frame chart? All that we see here is price is back inside its swing point. It's still trading inside the swing point. That's a swing point from July 21st, 2023. That swinged at 310 million shares. Last week, you were up into it with 251 million shares. Price is still inside that swing point. That would say as long as it's able to do that, with even without volume, price may want to target that 198.23 level. We have price above its oscillator and change line on the monthly time frame. The monthly swing point, now we're just too early in the month to know. Monthly swing point has nearly a billion shares, 996 million so far for the month. We have got 374, but just too hard for me to extrapolate what that's going to turn into at month end. So what do we know about Apple? Really just a consolidation after a topping pattern that was confirmed yesterday out there with inside its profiles. Let's see if a 30-minute chart has got any clues for us out here, Dennis. And on a 30-minute basis, we see that TD9 count top. price move lower. I don't have any reason why it found support where it did. If we look over to the left, we do see that big old breakout candle. There was 11, 12 million shares traded then as this thing was moving down to this low out here. It was with about 3 million shares. So what else do we see on a 30-minute time frame chart? I see price above. It's oscillator and change line above profile. So on a 30-minute basis, this seems pretty bullish to Stevie out there. So that would say, but you're still dealing with price, dealing with that resistance level of that center line of that profile. And that's where you begin the sell zone out there. Again, that's up at 193.43. So your upper resistance, you're asking, you know, what's this going to do short term? I don't know. If price were able to get above that center profile level, then I think we'd say 194.19 is in the cards, and above that, 195.14. So, Dennis, I hope that helped you out with both Apple and Microsoft. Thank you so much for taking the time to write in. Now, Joe wants, he's asking a question about UNG. We'll take a look at UNG out here, and then we'll go take a look at natural gas. And his question is, did UNG bottom? Now, if we just base our trade on UNG, you're going to see that yesterday was bar number 7. Today will become bar number 8. There's no sign of a TD9 count bottom out there when we take a look at the daily time frame. I don't think that's what we're going to see when we go take a look at the natural gas contract that makes up the UNG ETF. And that's really what you need to take a look at. Right now, UNG has 100%, well, I won't say 100%. With regard to futures contracts, it's only the January future contract. So we'll keep that in mind. When we look at the weekly time frame chart out here, Joe, for UNG, it needs a bullish reversal candle to confirm a bottom. If we take a look at the monthly time frame chart, you're trading below last month's low. There's no bottoming signal that I have out there, and that says we continue to move lower. Now, let's take a look at the seasonal pattern for UNG. And what does this tell us? This tells us the worst performing month of the year for natural gas is December. Period. End of story. This tells us that we really should continue to head lower. We can get some bounces out here, but we really should head lower. And it tells us that what UNG or natural gas doesn't really do, it doesn't really bottom until you get right about here. And that's the early part of February. Now, we're not going to use it right to the day. We're not going to necessarily use it right to the week. We know what to be looking for out here. And I don't think so. You're in the very unfavorable seasonal cycle time period out there when we take a look at UNG. Now let's go take a look at natural gas. We're going to go to a break here momentarily, but I should be able to at least pull up the natural gas charts out there. We take a minute out here. We take a look at natural gas. What you're going to see on the daily time frame, and I'll just simply expand this out, is you are going to see that bar number 8 is really what took place yesterday. And that says that natural gas should get a TD9 count bottom that forms between yesterday and tomorrow. And all that should really do is get us up to the oscillator and change line. So if you're a real intraday trader and you want to trade the futures contract, yeah, I can see that. Steve Rhodes with TFNN. We'll come back. We'll finish looking at natural gas.
Currencies, commodities, and bond markets are as important as ever right now with how they're driving the volatility in equity markets across the globe, which is why it's a great time to try out Teddy Kegstat's Tiger Forex Report. Teddy Kegstat breaks down the Forex markets every Monday using his 30-plus years of experience as a trading veteran of futures, Forex, stocks, and options. Teddy releases his weekly Tiger Forex Report every Monday morning with coverage of all the major currency pairs, including the dollar index, the euro dollar, pound dollar, dollar Swiss, dollar yen, as well as many more, and he also has weekly coverage of the crude oil market and the 30-year T-bonds as they both influence Forex markets tremendously. When you sign up for the Tiger Forex Report, you also gain instant access to Teddy's 60-minute webinar archive he just hosted, Forex Strategies and Fundamentals, What is Behind the Tiger Forex Report. For all the details and to start your 30-day Tiger Forex Report subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
Everything in the universe is governed by the Fibonacci sequence. This mathematical principle is responsible for everything from the most aesthetically pleasing artwork to patterns in the stock market. To stay on top of stock patterns you can take advantage of, sign up for the Fibonacci 24/7 newsletter at TFNN.com. When you subscribe, you'll get a weekly report from veteran day trader Larry Pesavento on stocks you need to pay attention to. And you can trust Larry's analysis. After all, he's got 45 years experience as a day trader. Larry will also provide daily charts, videos, and data on the key markets that he's tracking. Expect notifications from Larry on market movement you need to act on at any time. First-time subscribers also get a 30-day money-back guarantee. If you're not satisfied, let us know and you'll get a full refund within 30 days of signing up. Subscribe to the Fibonacci 24/7 newsletter today. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foresight Fund Services, LLC.
This program is brought to you by Vista Gold, traded on the NYSE American and TSX under the symbol VGZ.
Welcome back, folks. We're taking a look at the natural gas contract. This is the January contract. That's the contract that is inside a UNG, the ETF. That's what Joe was asking about. So if you take a look at yesterday, yesterday was an easy intraday trade to make inside of UNG. Why is that, Stevie? Take a look at all the bottom signals that we have out here. If you take a look at the five-hour time frame chart, you got down to wave number seven. That's letter G. While that was unfolding, on the two-hour chart, you had a TD9 count bottom that was forming. If we take a look at the 60-minute time frame chart, right at 10 o'clock, you completed a TD9 count bottom. If you take a look at the 30-minute time frame chart, you completed a TD9 count bottom at 10 o'clock as well. And what that led to was that led to a rally. That led to a rally where you got a TD9 count top on the 30-minute time frame, and that was into about 4 o'clock yesterday afternoon. Now what do we have out here? We take a look at a 30-minute time frame chart. You want to watch this. You've got a TD9 count bottom that has formed. So far, all that's led to on a 30-minute basis is a rally up to its oscillator and change line. That's not really good. Why is it not really good? Because it's red. And that tells us on a 30-minute base, we have a falling price oscillator below zero. But price is still trading with inside its support area. And the support area runs anywhere from $2.35 up to $2.40. That is its profile level. Now, if price takes out the TD9 count bottom that formed at 9:30 this morning, that low is at $2.33, we're going to get back and test yesterday's hammer candle, or likely get back and test yesterday's hammer candle out there. So your question was, I believe it was, is there a bottom? And I can guarantee you there is a TD9 count bottom that is going to go ahead and confirm today. Again, that pattern will complete tomorrow. Is it worth playing knowing the seasonal cycle and pattern that you're in? Well, the answer to that question is it could be out there. My preference is I'm going to wait. But that doesn't mean that that's the right decision out here. Now, why did Stevie say, why am I even focused on natural gas? Those of you know that earlier in the year, I was taking a look at this. Haven't really talked about it much. But the reason, and that's because a number of the patterns failed on the weekly and the monthly time frame. And that's what has me saying, you know, let's come back and take a look at next year. The reason I want to take a look at natural gas, if we take a look at where we're at right now, we are going to, on a yearly basis, confirm a TD9 count bottom. Remember, that pattern does not get completed until the following bar. Well, that would mean 2024. But you get to bar number 9. If you can get some bottoming signals, certainly on the daily first, then the monthly, then the weekly, then the monthly, and of course the intraday charts out there, then maybe we have something. But I just simply share with you what's going to need to take place in order for natural gas to get all of our attention is some type of close above its oscillator and change line on the daily time frame. We haven't seen a close above that since November 6th out there, so it's in a strong downward momentum move out there. So I hope that helps answer your question, Joe, and many others out there with regard to UNG, what it's doing, why did it rally yesterday, and you had multiple multiple TD9 count bottom pattern, so it had no choice but to just simply follow along and go ahead and rally out there. The question was that the bottom? Soon enough, we're going to find out. Let's go to Joe's next request. Many others out there were also, I'm sure, are also wondering. And his question is, did GDX bottom out here? So let's get off to the GDX charts. Give me a moment. We'll get to GDX out here. And the answer to that question is no. We don't have a bottom signal just yet. What does that need? So if we take a look at the GDX, you've got an A to B equals CD pattern to the downside. We're already at the 1 to 1.272, I believe. But here is the A to B point is right there. If I just simply move this over right there, you're going to see that we're beyond the 1 to 1. So we're at about the 1 to 1.272. We're going to form bar number 7 today. So what we're watching for here is a bullish reversal candle. If we get that, that would then confirm a Gartley buy pattern or a buy the D point pattern. They're both basically the same. Gartley buy when you have a strong upward momentum move, in this case here, and then you get a retracement, an A to B equals CD pattern, and you want to get in on that large move that was to the upside. That would be your Gartley buy pattern out there. Where is it that price could be headed to inside the GDX? Easily could head to 2768. That's its TD 9 count breakout level. That's another couple bucks lower from where we're trading. It's likely to do that if we see the weekly chart give up support. And support right now would be at 20. Well, one of the support levels would be at 2897. Now, there's a support zone of the GDX on its weekly time frame, Joe. That's between 2784 and 2897. All that tells us is to keep looking at the daily chart, looking for some type of bottoming pattern out there. So we don't have that as we speak right now. Looks to me like it wants to continue to head lower. We'll watch for a bullish reversal candle. That leads into really the next question out here, which came in from Mary Jo in Naples. Mary Jo, thanks so much for listening, and she wants to take a look at Goldilocks. Her question is, where will gold bottom? So that's a great question. Let's see if we can answer that question. We'll pull up the Goldilocks charts out here, and we take a look at gold. If we look at the daily time frame, I'll just simply expand that out. What we have out here is we have a sell the D point pattern. So this confirmed a sell the D point pattern. Here's your A to B. That's your TD 9 count bottom was the C point. And then we've got that bearish engulfing candle that formed on that nice rally into December 4th. So the next level of support out here for gold is at 1979.30. We're trading below profile support on the daily time frame out there. And so, and you're in bar number 7 today. That says you could get a TD 9 count pattern between Wednesday and Friday of this week. Could. Ideally, we'd see that pattern form on Mary Jo, and it would form above the 1979.30 level. Does it have to form above that? It doesn't, but it's nice to see a price moving back to a breakout level, form a bottoming signal. That would be more bullish. Doesn't guarantee anything. It just would be more bullish. Now, of course, we're going to need some participation from the U.S. dollar index if that happens. What I mean by that is if the U.S. dollar index were to close above, remember, or maybe you don't remember, but I'll simply come back to it. In fact, what I'll do is I'll switch charts. We'll switch panels because I can show it to you there just so that we don't miss that that little nuance. And it's important nuance. I just got to find it. Where is it? Here we go. Okay. So now we'll go ahead and switch charts. So we need some participation from the U.S. dollar index out there. And, of course, we can take a look at the other currency pairs, the major currency pairs. But, whoops, that's not what I wanted. Change screens. Let's get to the black background screen. And here we go. So now we take a look at the U.S. dollar index. And this is something else, Mary Jo, that we have to be watching. We can't, it's just not one thing that we can take a look at in order to analyze something. In a stock, it's more easy. It's easier to do, but not necessarily when we take a look at the gold contract. So if we take a look at gold, the U.S. dollar index. The U.S. dollar index closed above the top of its bearish structured profile. It did that on December 8th, and it did that yesterday, December 11th. Two consecutive closes above that. We also had that same pattern on December 5th and December the 6th. When you close above a bearish structured profile, if the move lower is only a countertrend move, price will find support at the center of that profile. And that is exactly what happened. The center is at 103.027, and the low so far today, 103.035. So price found support there. We're back above the profile. If the U.S. dollar index closes above 103.80, then what that's going to do is trigger an A to B equals C to the upside, 104.66. If that's what unfolds, then what I don't know is whether 1979.30 will hold. In fact, I would say the answer is likely not. What do you mean likely not, Steve? I mean, if that gives way and the U.S. dollar index starts to move higher, what this tells Stevie is we just had a two consecutive month run in gold to the upside. Look at we did that out here on the trading day of or the week, the month of April of 2023. Then what did we get? A two bar pullback. What did we get back here in August and September of 2021? A two bar pullback. We may get a bottom inside of gold in January. That's a possibility. I'm not making that call just yet. But if 1979 fails and the U.S. dollar index is above 103.80, I think that's what we're really looking at, Mary Jo. Steve Rhodes with TFNN. We'll be right back.
Get ready, Tigers. Thursday, December 14th, Tim Ord is back to host another stellar live webinar. From 4 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. Eastern Time, Tim Ord will delve into the secret science of market tops, helping you, the viewer, with how to effectively call market tops in order to increase your success in trading. Tim Ord has developed this understanding over decades of trading and is ready to impart this knowledge on you. Visit the front page of TFNN.com today to sign up for Tim Ord's secret science of market tops. TFNN, educating investors.
Ho, ho, ho!
It's December, Tigers. That means festivities, decorating, spending time with friends and family, and the TFNN Tiger Dollar Holiday Sale. Don't miss your chance to receive a 20, 30, or even a 40% bonus when you purchase Tiger Dollars. Once you apply your Tiger Dollars to your account, you will be able to use them for any TFNN product purchase instead of your credit card. Visit the front page of TFNN.com today to purchase your Tiger Dollars. Don't miss your chance to receive up to a 40% bonus on your Tiger Dollar purchase this holiday season. Every Tiger who purchases Tiger Dollars will also receive a complimentary TFNN Tiger mug with their purchase. Act fast, this sale ends December 17th. Happy holiday, Tigers. TFNN, educating investors.
You might think that if you want to be successful at trading in the stock market, you're going to need a crystal ball. After all, it's impossible to predict the future, right? Like any endeavor in life, before you decide it's impossible, get some advice from the experts. You might find that it's not so impossible after all. For daily market overviews that give you direction on the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, subscribe to the Opening Call newsletter at TFNN.com. The Opening Call newsletter is written by Basil Chapman, creator of the trading methodology known as the Chapman Wave. The Chapman Wave up-down sequence gives you an edge in identifying price turns, finding the peaks and valleys in stock prices. Get the Opening Call newsletter by Basil Chapman in your inbox every day. First-time subscribers also get a 30-day money-back guarantee. If you're not satisfied, let us know, and you'll get a full refund within 30 days of signing up. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Everything in the universe is governed by the Fibonacci sequence. This mathematical principle is responsible for everything from the most aesthetically pleasing artwork to patterns in the stock market. To stay on top of stock patterns you can take advantage of, sign up for the Fibonacci 24/7 newsletter at TFNN.com. When you subscribe, you'll get a weekly report from veteran day trader Larry Pesavento on stocks you need to pay attention to. And you can trust Larry's analysis. After all, he's got 45 years experience as a day trader. Larry will also provide daily charts, videos, and data on the key markets that he's tracking. Expect notifications from Larry on market movement you need to act on at any time. First-time subscribers also get a 30-day money-back guarantee. If you're not satisfied, let us know and you'll get a full refund within 30 days of signing up. Subscribe to the Fibonacci 24/7 newsletter today. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Welcome back, folks. We're taking a look at Bank of America. This is for Duncan Steve inside the Tiger's Den. So, Duncan, this is just up against a bunch of resistance. The first level of resistance to pay attention to is that weekly time frame chart, 3111. That's its TD9 count breakdown area. If price can close above that, that would be a bullish outcome. Now, if price can close above that, your next resistance area is going to be at 3201. That's the top of the monthly profile out there. With inside the daily time frame, We do not have any kind of a topping pattern. In order to get a topping pattern, you would need to get a bearish reversal candle. If you got that, you'd have a sell the D point pattern. Short of that, you just got a good old-fashioned consolidation with inside its profiles. That's between 3019 and 3088. So you just got to understand anything bearish. You just got price. Maybe it's trying to recharge to be able to take out those resistance zones, but that's what you're dealing with. One other resistance zone on the daily time frame is at 3140. So just a lot of resistance when you take a look at the Bank of America. Yes, was wondering if 27s-ish. So you can see them here on the chart. So you've got that data. And thanks so much for the request. So markets are moving higher. We got a little bit of a mixed bag out there. Let's just share this last thing with you as we depart. For every seller, there's a buyer. And we take a look at the U.S. indices out here. Who are the buyers? With certainty, who are the buyers? Well, we're at new all-time highs as we speak right now with the Dow priced in euros. I guarantee you they are buyers. In terms of the Japanese yen, we're at a new all-time high as well. If we take a look at the Great British Pound, it's targeting that all-time high at 23,902. They are also buyers. In Swedish Corona, we're trading into the all-time high. In Australian dollars, the Dow is at new all-time highs. Folks, you got to take a look at the Dow and how it trades, not just in U.S. dollars. We've got to understand what's going on around the globe. And this is that picture right now. Stay tuned for all the great programming, folks. I'll see you tomorrow. Have a terrific Tuesday. Be safe out there.